Vanakkam, welcome to 6W1H. This is Parthiben back with another video. Politics in workplace is a very common thing nowadays. It is all about competing for power and authority. This is definitely a game where winning is important no matter how. There might be bullying, manipulation, lying, stealing work or ideas. It is okay if you are able to tolerate them, but what if it is not your style? I mean if you are the nice guy. It might be a little hard to cope up, but remember, office politics is not rocket science. There is no need to worry, stress out, or betray your colleagues if you follow these 5 simple steps. Please bear in mind that honesty is always the best policy and hard work never fails. Let's begin. First tip, let your quality of work speak. Focus on your work and deliver. Promotion, hike in salary and power will automatically come to you. You don't have to involve yourself in dirty politics at work. Because you work hard and your work is very awesome, there will always be a set of people who wants to shut you down because they can't deliver. Don't sell yourself short, instead deliver quality in whatever work you do. Remember to be so good in your work that you're almost intimidating. If you do this, you are sure to stand out and create a positive impact in your work culture, which is good for you and for the company. The second tip is, create a friendly network. Trust me, having supportive friends who understand you and make you comfortable and happy while at work is very important. Sometimes you just can't withstand the pressure that is created out of office politics. This needs to be definitely sorted out. Talk with your friends in office whom you trust. But remember, you don't sit down there and get into a gossip. Research says that productivity in office can be increased by avoiding unnecessary gossip. It might be fun to sip a cup of coffee along with your friends and get into a gossip. But hey, remember, it will take you nowhere. When you meet with your friends in office, have a good time, motivate, support and encourage each other. Be the change, set an example so that the others in office can follow you. End of the day, your friends in office is your small little world where you can be yourself and forget about the madness happening in the office. The third tip is embracing a positive mindset. It can be so embarrassing and nasty when negativity tries to get hold of you. You should be socially astute. For example, a non-performer can easily surpass you at work by playing dirty politics. So don't dim your light. This is time to embrace a positive mindset and work towards achieving your career goal. When you are in a crisis, assess and anticipate situations. Be ready to adapt, customize your behavior and attitude based on the conditions and the people working around you. Once you have a positive mindset, things become simple and easy. Remember, you don't have to ignore or bypass workplace politics when it challenges you. After all, dealing with office politics is part and parcel of leadership development. Fourth tip is, feel free to reject pressure due to office politics. There is no need to participate in office politics, even if it is part of your work culture. If you are a lateral hire, once you join the company, try to observe and see how the others use the system to grow up the corporate ladder. Using the faulty system to get ahead might be easy, but it is never an achievement and a temporary workaround. Try being yourself, relax and relinquish tension. You have the right to reject pressure at any time. By doing this, you will definitely overcome fear and set your own course. Keep in mind that you will gain visibility and move ahead if you do things a little different. Tip is, shut down negativity and start leading. Corporate culture is always changing and moving. Don't react to it, just realize that you have the power to influence your colleagues. The change is within you, so don't forget to completely shut down the negativity and start playing an office politics that is more authentic and positive. When negativity has the power to play a lead role in the office politics, why can't positivity? It has its own charm, so be a game changer. Don't forget the old golden rule. What you give to the world comes back to you definitely. Once you are in power, feel empowered and be obliged to do good and uplift the like-minded. I really hope you find this video inspiring and useful. Please subscribe and join our community. See you soon in another video. This is Parthiben signing off. Take care. Bye.